it comes first. And when I explain this technique to people, it's called AVRT, and it's just called addictive voice recognition technique. And it's all about recognizing the difference between the right inner voice and you, and the part of you that's crying on a Tuesday saying, I fucking hate this. I want to stop. I don't want to do this anymore. I can't stand it. I'm not enjoying it. I'm paranoid. I'm skitzed out in the house. I'm drinking straight vodka. I'm having palpitations. I'm breathing into a fucking bag on a fucking Monday morning. And then as soon as my heart starts being normal, I'm fucking snorting cocaine again. What? Why? I hate it. I'm going to kill myself. I'm going to have a stroke. I'm not going to see my kids grow up. I'm lying in bed on a Tuesday with the weight of the world on my shoulders, with the worst thoughts. And then come Thursday, I'm getting these thoughts again.
That voice
these addictive
again.
Addictive thoughts, thinking, just have a little go Saturday. The fucking boxing's on. Liverpool playing, the matches on. They're all going to fucking Tommy's. That'd be good, that. Just go and have a couple. Just have a few. Just don't go mad. Don't go mad. Just have a couple. Tell your bird you're being bite 11 and just come home at 10:30. That's your addictive voice. Mm. And it's learning to separate that from you, the part of you that wants, that knows. There's a part of you knows that's not true.
Mm.
But it's only through learning and getting tricked by it all the fucking time that I realised and I mastered it. I mean, like, to a fucking T.
Mm.
I would know every little insinuation or trick, and it won't, like, if you've got an addiction, it won't just by going, I'm not doing it no more, your addiction's not going to go, all right, sound. Well, then, it just won't. Mm. I had to stop drinking as well. I went 6 months clean, 12 months clean, 4 years clean at one point. But I was still drinking now and again, and it was the drink. As soon as I got, and I was still getting lots of addictive voice and lots of addictive thoughts, but I was batting it off and batting it off and batting it off. And in the end, my counsellor said to me, you're going to have to stop drinking, because as soon as you drink, in the end, you're going to end up using again.
Yeah.
And so I did. But the technique I learned was just like about separating yourself from that voice and learning to recognise that all that is a part of is your addiction, that strong part of you, that's using your voice. It sounds quite complicated, but it's not.
Yeah.
You know,
it's like that little devil and the angel.
Of course it is, yeah. But what happens is your addiction will use, well, you can't use anyone else's voice. It's not going to fucking come out like a fucking lad from St. Helens. Hey, Lee, fucking boxing's on Saturday. Once you get in a fucking couple of bags, you'll be on by 11. You're not going to fucking go mad again. Fucking, your bird sounds, you're fucking back on board now. Have a couple Saturday. It uses your voice so you can think it's you.
Yeah.
You can get tricked very easily by these very clever fucking addictive thoughts and voices. Mm.